It's a wonder I can think at all. And my lack of
what's the line in this that's gonna be about our show, man?
It's not gonna be Kodachrome.
That's gotta be. Here it comes. Take that, Jason!
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a show intro right here.
First. Yeah, we should mention we were pretty embarrassed by Jason's fancy graphics and music, so we thought we would one-up him.
That's right. And if you're wondering who we're talking about with Jason, Jason's a loyal follower and he's become a friend, and he invited, or I guess we invited ourselves onto his show. He's got a wonderful YouTube channel. So I will put all the information in the show notes below. Please make sure to go view and sign up and subscribe to Jason's channel. He's what?
Let's make this clear. If people are only going to sign up for one show.
Oh, ours.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So don't be going and signing up for his unless you've already signed up for ours. Yeah.
John, I have got such a tremendous headache today. It's like this big spear going through my hip.
It's because you have a spear going through your head.
I got to get myself a little realigned here. So what are we talking about today?
That great intro. People have been saying our 800 followers have been begging us to be more professional. We want feedback now on that. That was pretty epic. You wouldn't believe how long it took us to do that.
Yeah, I worked a long time on that drawing, on that...
And to try to figure out how we share and record at the same time, it was like work.
How to use the colored pen inside the letters, that was tough.
Oh my gosh.
What are we talking about?
So my notes say our next one on our list is, why do we gravitate towards the toys and the equipment and the new technique in Photoshop or Lightroom or whatever? Why are we so drawn to that stuff? Versus, and I know what you're going to say.
Well, I've just noticed there are people who aren't. There are people who just seem to be very artistic. They kind of shun technology. They try to stay in touch with more creative things and creative environments. And then there's us, typically photographers, who are always reading the gear reviews, always comparing lenses, always comparing specs. And we also tend to be rule followers. We talk about, the optimal aperture on our lens or the things that, we're going to talk about that later, things that don't matter. So why is that? Are we born that way?
Yeah. Or is it just a phenomenon of photography? Do you think artists, and I think you did mention this in a prior episode, that you do have a friend who does spend time talking about the type of brushes?
Well, he read my article once about, I think it's called an imaginary conversation between Picasso and I forget. And it talked about how they were comparing what brushes they used, what stools they used, what satchel they used, what canvases they used. And then at the end, I wrote something to the effect, I'm glad we as photographers don't do that. And he read the article and he's an accomplished painter and said, well, actually, painters do that.
Interesting.
I didn't know that. They talk about different paints and brushes and et cetera.
Yeah. So
I don't know.
But I think the point of the episode today is to once again just lovingly encourage folks to spend more time on the vision part of that equation, and remind people of your rule. Speaking of rules before, that we tend to be rule followers, your rule of thirds. But I asked you to remind them.
I thought you were going to say that.
Oh, well, I don't remember because I don't care about your rule of thirds.
that a great image is made up of one third vision, one third the shot, and one third processing. But it's the vision that comes first and is driving the shot and is driving the processing, because for too long I focused only on the shot and the processing. I was out of balance.
Yeah.
And I think someone might say, well, can't I do both? Can't I also be a gearhead and also focus on the creative side? And I suspect it's theoretically possible, but when I see people, it tends to be either really one direction or the other. Yeah. And if you had to choose, I would say focus on the creative, and then you only get involved with the technical when there's a need, when there's a requirement, when there's something that you can't do and it requires some equipment. Then, you know, then we focus on the tool that will help best execute our vision.
Well, your iceberg, you know, image, you know, where you had to figure out how to make it look like smoozy water, you know, and you didn't know how. And so you phoned a friend with your one phone a friend card that you have. And
didn't call you, by the way, you know,
which was smart, very smart. Yeah. I noticed that. I was hurt for a second. Then I realized I was actually quite brilliant not to call me. But yeah, no, you figure it out later. But yeah, the concern I have is when, you know, people who come on tours with us is that they're asking so many questions about the gear side and what lens did you shoot that with? And man, do you like that lens better than that lens? And while there is a place and a time for all of that discussion, and there are times when a sharper lens is probably appropriate, but we would prefer you spend more time thinking about the vision side of what is it that you're trying to say, express, emote, or what have you with your work, and make that the priority rather than do I need a new lens?
And I think most of us would agree that what we think about, talk about, read about the most is where our emphasis is going.
Mm-hmm.
And so let's balance things out, folk. And in fact, I would say for most of my life, having been over to the one side, focused on the technical, it doesn't hurt now to try to correct that balance by overemphasizing and focusing on the creative.
You know, what I've been reading a lot is, you said, what do I focus on? I focus on lens work, all articles in lens work, especially when it includes Cole Thompson. All right. So focus on the creative, focus on the expressive, focus on
what you love.
Yeah, there you go. What do you love? And then, you know, the technical, worry about that later.
Yeah. What's that saying you've got? Photograph what makes your heart hum. I mean, no, heart. Sing what makes
like
your heart
Kodachrome.
Sing.
Kodachrome. Hey, all right.
Do we end the episode with that same?
I don't think I could possibly make that happen again.
Okay. We'll do it next time.
I'll talk to Jason and see if he can help me figure out the whole intro thing like professionally. You probably got to do it in post-processing, and I have no desire to learn video post-processing. So people, you're stuck with our crude techniques here. See you, Cole.
Bye.